Now we've seen conjugacy classes, and there's actually we can play with it a bit. And a nice way to play with it is just to look at the symmetric group. And if we do it the symmetric group, there is something that comes out of conjugation that is actually quite important. So it's not just all play. So what is the symmetric group in n elements? Remember, that is the quintessential one because that just contains all the permutations of a set. So if my set is, remember, if we had a set and my set was A and A contained 1, 2, and 3, all the permutations of that, and I gave each permutation just a symbol. So remember, we had the identity one, we had tau 1, 2, we had tau 1, 3, we had tau 2, 3, we had sigma, and we had sigma squared. And sigma took 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 back to 1, and doing it twice took 1 to 3, 3 to 2, and 2 back to 1. So you remember how it's just all the permutations, and remember the number that there will be. There's 3 here, so the number of elements will just be n factorial. So we remember that. Quite easy to do, that is that. Now let's just look at cycle types, and what I want to do is use one that's often in the books, and that is just to look at S5. So we're going to have 5 elements, and we're going to have 5 factorial possible permutations, and each of them will name something. Let's just look at a very specific one, one that you commonly see in books. Let's have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there. And let's just look at one of these possible permutations. Let's take 1 down to 4. Let's take 4 goes to 3. And let's make 3 go back to 1. And let's make 2 go to 5. And let's make 5 go to 2. That's a nice complicated one. I hope you can see it back all the way from where the camera is. Anyway, there we go. Let's do cycle composition of that. Remember how we do that? So the cycle decomposition of it, we'll start with the smallest one, which is 1, and we see 1 goes to 4, and then 4 goes to 3, and 3 goes all the way back to 1. So 3 goes back to 1, so that's one cycle complete, and 2 goes to 5, and 2 goes to 5, and 5 goes to 2, and that is done. Remember, if there is a single one, we don't, you know, if there's just a 1, we don't change it. For identity element, we would just write that as 1. This one, we would just write as 1, 2 for this S3. Remember, this is S3 now, the symmetric group in 3 elements. This we would write 1, 3. We don't write the 3 there. We don't write the 2 there. The reason why is we have these names. This one is called a 3 cycle. Because it's just this cycle. I can create 2 cycles here. And this one is a two cycle, and then the 1 cycles we just leave them out. Now let's just consider one other one, and I want to show you this one. So this will actually have a name. This is a 3 cycle, 2 cycle, and that's the cycle type of this permutation. Now, and for the fun of it, we'll just call this sigma. That's my sigma permutation. So let's just have a look at another one possible one. Let's have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And let's do something else. Let's make 1 go to 2. 1 go to 2. We'll make 2 go to 3. We'll make 3 go to 1. We'll make 4 go to 5. And we'll make 5 go to 4. So we're left with 1 going to 2, going to 3, going to 1. And we're left with 4 going to 5. Note that this is a 2 cycle. And that 3 cycle, I should say, and that is a 2 cycle. And look at these two. It's a 3 cycle, 2 cycle, 3 cycle, 2 cycle. That is what this one is. It's a 3 cycle, 2 cycle. That one's a 3 cycle, 2 cycle. That's its cycle type of this permutation, of that permutation, and both of them are the same cycle types. And there's something very specific about these 2 cycle types. Because what I can show you is I can change this permutation into that permutation just by rearranging this 3 cycle, rearranging this 2 cycle, and it is because it is that cycle type, 3 and 2, and 3 and 2, that I can do this. If it was a 4, it's just a 4, because we won't say 4 and 1, but if it was a 4 and 1, and 4 and 1, I can convert one into the other one very simply. Because look what happened here. 1, 4, 3. I've got 1, 2, 3. So it seems if I can change, let's put something else out here. Let me put it down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we'll call this sigma. And sigma took 1 to 4. It took 2, it took 4 to 3. It took 3 back to 1. It took 2 to 5. And it took 5, it took 5 to 2. There we go. And I want to change it into that. Now, if you look at this one, and you look at this one, it seems as if we can just take 2 to 4. I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on this side. If I would just be able to take 2 to 4, and 4 to 2, and if that happens, 2 and 4, I just need to swap that 2 and 4 around, then this one becomes that one. No problem. So 1 will stay at 1, 3 will stay at 3, and 5 will stay at 5. And let me just do it this side, and you'll see now I'm going to do it this side as well. So 1 stays with 1, 2 goes to 4, 3 stays with 3, 4 goes to 4, and 5 goes to 5. That seems to be the only thing that I need to change to do this. And the reason why is I don't have to change where my cycle ends, because that's a 3, and that's a 3, and that's a 2, and that's a 2. That's all I need to do. And I'm going to call this permutation tau. And it's there again. I mean, I've just written it out in reverse. And what we can see now is if we do this tau, which is just going to be one of the elements in S5, if I turn it into tau's inverse, what does the inverse do? Well, it just turns the arrows around, and now they go that way. So if I go from here to here, that would be tau inverse. This is still sigma, and this is still tau. So if I have tau composed with sigma, composed with tau inverse. Remember how we do that? We do the last one first, then this one, then this one. It will just be as if I go along this way. So if I do this in this direction, that would be tau inverse. There's sigma, and there's tau. And let's see if I can land up there if I do that. So let's see what happens to 1. 1 goes to in the inverse, doing tau inverse first. 1 goes to 1, goes to 4, goes to 2, so 1 goes to 2, that's nice, I'm getting there. What happens to 2? 2 goes to 4, to 3, to 3, it goes to 3, hey, it's getting there. What happens to 3? 3, to 3, to 1, to 1, goes back to 1, that works. What happens to 4? 4 goes to 2, goes to 5, goes to 5, 4 goes to 5, and then the old 5 will have to go to 5, where are we? 5 goes to 5. Inverse to 2 to 4. Where did it? So 5 goes to 4. So 4 goes to 5 and 5 goes to 4. And there we have it. I have this one. And look what I did here. I did conjugation. I did conjugation. And now think of the conjugacy class. What is the conjugacy class here of sigma? If I were to do sigma, remember how we do that? That is, I'll say it's tau composed with sigma, composed with tau inverse, for all tau being an element of, in this instance, whatever my group was. That was conjugacy. And now you can see something, which is actually the important thing here, is that all the cycle types, if I look at the conjugacy class, remember, and this is going to partition my group, my whole group, is that all of the elements in the conjugacy class will have the same cycle type. Because I showed you what conjugation actually is. Conjugation is actually changing one cycle type into another cycle type. And those two are exactly the same cycle types. That's all that conjugation is doing for me. So it's another way to view what conjugation actually does. Because from what we've seen here, all the conjugacy classes, all the elements in the conjugacy class will actually have the same cycle type. So it'll be a 3-2, and a 3-2, and a 3-2, and another 3-2, or 2-3, 2-3, 2-3, 2-3, whatever the conjugacy class might be. So very nice sort of insight into the cycle I suppose this is something new that we learned, that cycle type, and that all the elements in the conjugacy class will be of that exact same type.